Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, we're going to provide you with a high-level overview of one of the most important financial statements, the statement of cash flows. We'll start off by answering the question to, what is a statement of cash flows? Next, we'll get into understanding the nuts and bolts behind it all. And finally, we'll dive into the types of critical insights that can be gathered from reading this statement. Whether you're looking to be a manager in a business, start your own company, or even become an investor, a general understanding of the statement of cash flows will arm you with the tools you need to make critical business decisions. So why is this statement of cash flows so important? Well, you can think of a business like a shiny new sports car. Sometimes the exterior looks great, but in order to get the full picture, we need to be able to pop open the hood and take a look at what's happening under the surface. The statement of cash flows is the toolbox that allows us to peek under the hood and poke around to get a sense of how a business is managing its cash. Now, cash is king in a business, as it's one of the key resources that allows companies to continue to operate into the future. Understanding where a company is getting its cash and how they're putting it into use in the business can give us great insight into the company's likelihood of future success. If an external user, such as a bank or investor, wants to find out how much cash a company has, they can very quickly look at a company's balance sheet. Now, while the balance sheet tells us the actual amount of cash sitting in the company, it doesn't tell us anything about where the money came from and where it's being spent. This is where the statement of cash flows works its magic by showing us the flow of every dollar, breaking it down into three categories of business activities: operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. Why does this even matter? Well, if you are an investor in an organization, wouldn't it be nice to know what the company is actually doing with your hard-earned money? Is it being used to buy new supplies or equipment, or are they actually using it to pay management's bonuses? Understanding this statement can arm users with crucial information about a company's performance. Anytime we have an accounting transaction where money changes hands, it gets grouped into one of these three categories and reported on the statement of cash flows. Financing activities are the means by which a company raises funds into the organization. Usually, this would be done by either equity financing or debt financing. If we take into account all the funds received from financing and subtract out any dividends paid, this leaves us with the total cash flows from financing activities. Investing activities give external users information about how a company is using their profits they've received from investors. If a company spends money on a new building, some land or equipment, this would all fall under a company's investing activities. On the statement of cash flows, we would see the total cash flow from investing activities reflected by all the cash received from the sale of long-term assets, less any cash paid out to acquire any new assets that period. Last, but certainly not least, are the operating activities. This is the category where all the day-to-day business transactions occur. This includes the revenue a company receives for selling a good or service, as well as all the expenses that the company incurs to operate the business, such as rent, utilities, wages, and taxes. On the statement of cash flows, we would see the total cash flow from operations reflected by the cash received from the sale of goods or services, less any cash paid out for operating expenses in that period. These three categories of business activities hold the key to companies' most important financial information, and understanding how they manage their cash in these areas can be valuable information for users of the financial statements. Now that we have a general understanding of the information you can find on a statement of cash flows, there's a couple of things we want to watch out for. There's been numerous examples of past companies that have not survived, even though they appeared to be profitable. This was likely due to their inability to effectively manage their cash. Many users of the financial statements rely usually only on the balance sheet or income statement to make their decisions. However, neither of these two statements tell the user about the specific sources or uses of cash in a business. And while the income statement reports the net profit for a particular period, this doesn't actually equal the cash flows from operations. The principal financial statements are a package deal. You really need to look at all three together to gather the most insight. Let's take a look at an example of how the statement of cash flows works, relating it directly to both the balance sheet and the income statement. Going back to the analogy from earlier, the balance sheet is like the sports car. It shows us the shiny cash balance at the beginning and end of a race, whereas the statement of cash flows is where we look under the hood to get an understanding of where the changes in the cash balance actually came from. Say, for example, on July 1st, the balance sheet reported an opening cash balance of $50,000 and a closing balance at the end of the month was down to $10,000. Where did that $40,000 difference go? Did the company lose the money that month from poor operational performance? Let's go take a look at the income statement to find out. Wait a second, this doesn't seem right. We were expecting to see a $40,000 loss. However, the July income statement is showing net profit that month of $100,000. Well, how can that be? Remember, profit does not equal cash flow. We may not have received all of those funds in cash yet this month, due to some of it still being outstanding. Either way, we still don't have enough information yet. So let's see if the statement of cash flows holds the answer. Remember, we're trying to determine what happened during the month that caused the company's total cash to go from $50,000 down to $10,000. The statement of cash flows shows us exactly where this $40,000 difference comes from. If we look under the operating activities, we see the $100,000 profit, which was the amount on the income statement. However, we can see that $70,000 of this still remains outstanding as an accounts receivable. This means that they only received a portion of those funds, resulting in an increase to cash of $30,000 from their operating activities. We're now at a total cash balance of $80,000. However, if we look a little lower down in the statement, we see that the company spent $60,000 on a new equipment to purchase, which results in a decrease to the cash balance from their investing activities. In addition, if we look under the financing activities, they look to have issued $10,000 worth of cash dividends to their investors, resulting in a decrease to the cash balance by this amount. So now, if we sum up the total from all three activities, we can see the $40,000 change in cash has now been accounted for. This brings us to that ending cash balance of $10,000. Looking at this statement of cash flows has now made it crystal clear how the company's cash balance got from point A to point B during the month of July. And that brings us to the end of this video. The statement of cash flows provides us with critical information about a company's ability to manage their cash when it comes to their operating, investing, and financing activities. Understanding how to read and make decisions from this information within this financial statement is a critical skill in today's business world. While we just skimmed the surface here in this video, if you're interested in learning more, please feel free to check out our additional videos where we dive even deeper into each of these financial statements.